I've been in so many Disney films.
Yeah, and you did a lot of voiceover.
And I did a lot of voices, and I guess they wanted me to come back to see what the body looked like.
Maybe. Looks pretty good. Now, you're doing these voiceovers, for anybody who might not know it, there'll be a cartoon character on the screen. The voice has to be done by somebody, the actual sound. And Sterling has done many, I guess, more than you can remember.
Yeah, well, let's see. I was Flower the Skunk in Bambi.
Yeah.
And I was a Stork in Dumbo. And I was a Cat in Alice in Wonderland. And they all sound exactly the same. There's nothing much I can do about the voice.
No, but the voice fits so many things. You did, I remember with pleasure, Peter and the Wolf, did you not?
Yeah, I did that. I was the first one to do that in this country.
Yes, a story.
Very well, a story.
Once upon a time, there was a little house on a little hill way out in the country. She was a happy little house, for she loved the country life. The peace and quiet, the warm sun on her roof, and the whisper of the summer breeze round her eaves. It was only at night that the little house felt just a little bit lonely and wondered what it would be like to have other houses around to talk to. Then she would gaze wistfully toward the distant lights of the city, never realizing that all the time those lights were coming closer and closer. Gracious me, thought the little house. What perfectly elegant neighbors. My, my, thought the little house. What a pity. Still, they weren't very nice. The years rolled faster now, and the little house saw the dawn of a new century. The tempo of life had quickened. Everything was bigger and better, for this was the age of progress. If only I could go with them, thought the little house. But of course, she couldn't. Come what may, she had to stand her ground. But the little house felt that she could never, never be happy again. Not with this awful, empty feeling inside. Well, there's one thing about progress. It always progresses. Well, good riddance. Maybe now I can have a little peace and... Uh-oh. Now what? And still the city grew. Reaching upward, higher and higher, the sky was the limit. Oh dear, what's to become of me? Will I never see the sun again? Or feel the gentle touch of the summer breeze? Or hear the song of the meadowlark?
Okay, let's get it over with.
Yes, get it over with. I'm just in the way. No good to anybody. But land sakes, I shouldn't complain. I've had a very full life for a house. And we all have to go sometime.
Thank you.
wasn't the end after all. It was just the beginning. Oh, it took a little time and a lot of fixing, but all that really mattered was that she'd found someone. Or rather, they'd found her. Someone to love and cherish her. Someone who knew that the best place to find peace and happiness is in a little house on a little hill way out in the country.
How's he coming, Mac?
Who knows? It may live.
Well, you've been at it an hour now. I could build a new set in half the time.
Oh, is that so?
Sure. And you better get wise. I didn't just step off the ferry from Jersey. I know how you guys operate.
Do you?
Yeah, naturally. First you kill a $5 hour. Then you say you gotta take the set down to the shop. Another $20. Then you start switching tubes around at $2.50 a crack. I get some poor suckers all once and he gets mine. It's a racket, that's what it is. A penny ante costa nostra. So save yourself a headache, see? I ain't swinging for no big bills.
In that case, the set's ready.
What?
It's ready. And this time it's on me. Free.
Hey, wait a minute.
Well, you can't want them all.
I didn't really mean it. I killed her. I killed her.
Fix your set okay, mister? You will recommend my service, won't you? Trust in me, just in me. Shut your eyes and trust in me. Hold still, please. You can sleep safe and sound, knowing I'm around. Slip into silent slumber, sail on a silver mist. Slowly and surely your senses will cease to resist. Trust in me and just in me.
Came to me and he said, with such a stickler for voices, he said, when you finished what you're doing today on Winnie the Pooh, he said, fiddle around, see what you can do with a snake. He said, I can't get the right voice. So I thought, wouldn't it be funny to have a snake with an aching back, because it would be such a long ache.
Ooh, my set really ache.
Thank you. There's no sort of use in your knocking.
Please, sir, how am I to get in?
I shall sit here till tomorrow.
I'm sorry you were hit, but how am I to get in?
I shall sit here for days and days.
But what am I to do?
Anything you like.
Now, let's see. Where was I? I wonder which way I ought to go.
The brilliant and the slimy toes did to guile and gimble in the way. All amusing were the warbles and the warm rats out to play.
Now, where in the world do you suppose that...
Lose something.
Oh!
Lose something.
I was just wondering.
Oh, that's quite all right.
One moment, please. Ooh. Second chorus. "'Twas brilliant, and the slithy toves did a gyre and a gimbal in the wave.
Why, you're a cat.
A Cheshire cat.
Dull a mimsy. Oh, the water goes.
Oh, wait! Don't go, please!
Very well. Third chorus.
Oh, no. Thank you, but I just wanted to ask you which way I ought to go.
Well, that depends on where you want to get to.
Oh, it really doesn't matter.
Yeah. As long as
then it really doesn't matter which way you go. I have some friends who go that way, and then others go that way. But as for me, myself, personally, I always take the shortcut.
Oh, by the way, if you'd really like to know, he went that way.
Who did?
Who did? The White Rabbit.
Oh, he did?
He did what?
Went that way.
Who did?
The White Rabbit.
What rabbit?
But didn't you just say,
can you stand on your head? However, if I were looking for a White Rabbit, I'd ask the Mad Hatter.
The Mad Hatter?
Mm-hmm.
No, I don't want to...
Well, then you could always ask the March Hare in that direction.
Oh, thank you very much.
Of course, you know he's mad, too.
But I don't want to go among mad people.
Oh, my dear child, you can't help that. We're all mad here. Everybody's mad.
You may have noticed that I'm not all there myself. And the more I...
Goodness.
Oh, quiet, little girl. Oh, here's an unbirthday present for you.
Thank you.
Quiet. If I were you, I would not talk so much.
Why?
Because I heard the Queen say just yesterday that you ought to be beheaded.
What for?
Oh, I don't know what for. She didn't say. Mind your own business. Read your book. Oh, I'm pale.
Oh, this is all in some language I don't understand.
That is in Jabberwocky.
Oh, may I borrow this mirror, please, for a minute?
Well, if you must, yes.
Oh, this is a looking glass look, of course.
Of course.
When I put the mirror this way, the words all come the right way again.
Well, let me see. May I see?
Oh, yes, certainly.
Oh, thank you. It's a wonderful book, isn't it?
Huh? Very good.
Oh, it's a lovely book. I think we ought to have something about it explained. It's very bewildering to me.
Well,
it's not really bewildering.
Oh, it isn't?
Now, I tell you, we've got some sketches here. Would you like
to
see them?
Oh, I'd love to see.
Sure.
But before we do the sketches, would you tell me, what's the meaning of brillig?
It's 4 o'clock in the afternoon.
4 o'clock in the afternoon? Brillig is 4 o'clock in the afternoon. What about, is it toves?
Toves, yes. Well, a tove is something like a badger and something like a lizard and something like a corkscrew.
What about a borogove?
Well, a borogove is a sort of a thin, emancipated-looking bird.
Emancipated.
Feathers sticking out all around, kind of a live moth.
What about the mom rat?
Well, isn't that something like a something like a green pig or something?
Yes, that's the green pig. That's the rat part. The mom, I wouldn't know.
Is it true that you act the scenes out completely before the camera, that is, before the artists have a chance, the cartoonists have a chance to do their work?
Yes, that's for the inspiration of the artists. So
the inspiration?
They can draw, yes.
I see. Well.
Well, that was it.
Sterling and Alice, or shall we say Kathy and...
Cheshire,
yes. Well, it doesn't matter. You're confusing no matter what happens. If the rest of the picture is as wonderful as that, I can hardly wait.
Duchess, kittens in trouble. Butler did it.
Duchess and kittens in trouble. Look, you go get Scat Cat and his gang of alley cats.
Alley cats? But I'm a mouse.
Look, I'm gonna need help.
You mean you want me?
Move! Just tell him O'Malley sent you and you won't have a bit of trouble.
No trouble, he said. Well, that's easy for what's-his-name to say. He's got 9 lives. I've only got 1.
What's a little swinger like you doing on our side of town?
Oh, please, I was sent here for help by a cat.
Well, this is outrageous. It's crazy.
But honest... He told me just to mention his name.
So, start mentioning name, rodent.
No. Oh, no, wait a minute, fellas. Look, don't rush me. His name is O'Toole.
I don't dig him. Strike one.
O'Brien.
Strike two.
Oh, boy. You believe me, don't you?
Keep talking, Mousy.
How about Grady? Huh?
Mousy, you just struck out. Any last words?
Well, why did I listen to that O'Malley cat? O'Malley? O'Malley?
O'Malley?
Hold it, cats. This little guy's on the level.
You darn tootin', I'm on the level.
Oh, we didn't mean it to ruffle you, Squeaky.
Don't worry about me.
Radar shows trouble ahead. But are we kittens or are we cats? We can do it. I thank you.
Damn!
Well, what's the good word, bird?
I am not a bird.
I know a lot of buzzards would be mighty pleased to hear that.
My name is Eustace Fentwick III.
The third? Don't tell me this has happened 3 times before, man. Well, crazy, what can I do for you, Mr. Useless Bentstick?
The name is Fentwick.
So, what can I do for you, Mr. Airwick?
Young man, I once buried a man just like you.
Oh, not like me, Dad. I'm the original. I am the thing.
Everybody wants to be a cat, because the cat's the only cat who knows where it's at. Everybody's picking up on that feline beat, because everything else is obsolete. Now a square with a home makes you wish you weren't born every time he plays. With a square in the act, he can set music back to the cave. Stuff like that when where it's at. We're playing jazz, you always have a welcome mat. Cause everybody digs a swinging cat.
I have just one word for you.